In this video, you will learn about a fast and easy way to find profitable product which you can sell on Amazon marketplaces. As an Amazon seller, you're probably struggling to find a product to sell on Amazon. Sometimes it really can take weeks or even months to find the right winning product because there are so many factors to consider. You need to think about product category you want to enter and sell your product in. You have to see if it's competitive, how many sellers are already selling this product, how many reviews other sellers have, and so on. So there are a lot of factors to consider, and you have to do it very carefully because all these, they determine the success of your Amazon product and the chances to outrank the competition. Actually, you can get all this information in one tool, which is part of Helium 10's suite. And for this, I invited Helium 10's evangelist, Adriana Rangel, to show this product, this tool inside Helium 10, which is called Black Box. And it will help you to find a profitable product to sell quite fast and easy. If you would like to try Helium 10 yourself, find the link below in the description. Also, there is information about the coupon code which you can use and get 10% off your monthly subscription lifetime or 50% off your first month with Helium 10. And as always, if you like videos we create, don't forget to click like below this video and subscribe to our channel.
Hi guys, my name is Adriana Rangel and I am a brand evangelist at Helium 10. I am excited to be here with you to share tips and strategies to find your next product to sell on Amazon. I am an international brand evangelist, meaning that I also create content in Spanish. So I also can do trainings and demo for you guys in Spanish if that's your preferred language. So, okay, let's jump right ahead. I'll share with you my screen. Okay, so here we are. This is the dashboard, of course, of Black Box. And as you can see, we have several different tabs in here that we can choose from. So we have the products tab, the keywords tab, competitors, niche, product targeting. Each tab, of course, serves a different purpose. But I would like to focus on the products tab. And perhaps even if we have time, we can look a little bit into the keywords tab. And this is mainly so, as the name suggests, products. This tab is to find products, right? To find products by using the several different filters that we have over here. As you can see, we have the main filters, which are the categories, monthly revenue, price, etc. And we also have some more advanced filters over here, just so we can filter down all the information that's available via this tool to find profitable products and profitable niches as well. So let's go right ahead and try an example over here. So the first filter that we'll use is categories. And in here, I'm just going to go ahead and choose, let's say I'm going to choose home and kitchen, perhaps health and household, kitchen and dining. If you have a preferred category that you would like to choose, you would do that over here. I usually actually even mark all of them and just deselect the ones that are related to electronics or books, because books, of course, and CDs and video games have IP patents and also licensing, perhaps, that you wouldn't want to deal with, at least not in your first product, right? So for now, I'm just going to choose these three categories. And let's jump right ahead into the monthly revenue filter. And the monthly revenue filter, that is one that I always want to make sure that I use, and because I do want to find products that have enough, you know, revenue coming in, enough sales, that make enough sales, at least, let's say, 10 sales a day, just so we don't find a product that is not, you know, that doesn't have that many sales coming in every month. So in here, I'm going to say, you know what, Black Box, please give me a product that brings in at least $5,000 in revenue, in monthly revenue, right? And so in the maximum, I'll just leave it open and see what this tool gives me. And we have the price filter over here that I always make sure to use, because I like in here to put a minimum of $20. And that is because I don't want to find products on the cheaper side, because that is mainly actually where most of the competition is. And that's not a place that I myself like to be, because those products over there have as I said, a ton of competition and they have very small margins, right? And so because of that, you have to focus basically on selling a lot of units per month in order to make some profit, right? And if something goes wrong, let's say that, you know, your PPC campaigns are not optimized or whatever, you might lose some of the, it's very easy to lose some of that very small margin that you have available in their profit margin. So that is why I like to stay on top of that 20, even actually 25 price range as a minimum would be actually optimal. And I also like to use a maximum because, especially when you're launching your first or your second product, you know that you need to, of course, invest some money to buy inventory, right? And since every factory has, of course, a minimum order quantity, you want to make sure you selecting here or you choose a product that is not super expensive, because let's say that the cost of your product is $80 and the factory asks you for a minimum order quantity of 200 units. There you would be needing to deal with more of a hefty inversion, initial investment, right? For the initial inventory, right? So that is why we want to make sure, in here I'm just gonna use 45 as the maximum price because I want to perhaps find a product that the price of the cost of the product in China, let's say, is $25, and that way I don't have to put in a ton of money for the first batch of inventory, right? So in here in the review count, that is also a filter that I never want to miss. So most of the times I make sure I use actually all of the filters that I have here, like the more, I don't want to say basic filters, but the ones that you really need to take care of. And so in here in the review count, I want to add, I'm going to say 75 for the maximum count of reviews, right? Because as you know, when you launch a product, you're starting from zero, right? So you from zero reviews, and you, of course, you can work with strategies and perhaps sign up to a few programs that Amazon has that where they actually encourage people to review your products. So that way you start getting some reviews, right? But from the start, you start from zero. So you want to make sure you don't compete in a niche where there's, where, you know, most products have on average, you know, 1,000 reviews or 10,000 reviews. It's actually not far-fetched, you know, to find products that are, that have over 1,000 reviews in Amazon.com at least. And perhaps in other marketplaces, there are, you know, products with less reviews because perhaps they're new marketplaces like even Amazon Mexico. I know that there are products in there that have much less reviews, really. And so that is why we want to use in here the 75 review count as a maximum. I'm going to leave the review rating open for now, and I'll show you in a little bit why. I'll leave it open for this example over here. But I do want to make sure that in here I put a 1 as a maximum in the variation count because, you know, initially for our initial analysis, we want to find a product that doesn't have many variations. Let's say that the variation is color and that we are looking at a coffee cup. And so let's say that this product specifically has a black coffee mug or and a white coffee mug and a red coffee mug, then it's going to be a little bit harder for us to choose from, you know, in this case, from those variations and be able to know right away what is the variation that is making the most money, right? The best seller, whether it be the red one or the black one or the white one. And that actually requires a little bit more of an analysis, which is possible, of course. But for now, let's keep it simple and just choose, try to find a product that has only one variation, as well as only perhaps two sellers, because we don't want to buy basically to launch a product in a niche that has a lot of arbitrage going on. So let's see, let's actually run a search. Okay, so this is, so we get over 200 products in here that the tool has found for us. So as you can see, we get a ton of different products. And the first thing that we want to make sure is that that search actually gives us products within the parameters that we chose. So in this case, we see that this one has up to two sellers, which is great because that's what we wanted. And it's in the price range that we were looking for. And also it only has 17 reviews, which is great actually. The review, so it has 4.8 stars, which is kind of high, actually. But it's 70 reviews. Perhaps we can launch something in this niche that get more reviews than that, right? So thank you very much, guys. And of course, I'm here to so we can always talk about this type of strategies. And I also, as I said, for anyone that wants to learn about this topic in Spanish, I am happy to be here to help. Thank you, guys.
I hope you enjoyed this video with Helium 10's Evangelist. If you want to try Helium 10, find the link below in the description. Also, you'll find information about available coupon codes, which can give you either 10% off lifetime or 50% the first month. And now I would like to invite you to watch the playlist, the whole playlist of videos we recorded about and with Helium 10.